Hello, welcome. Today I wanted to show you a little bit of colouring with our watercolour pencils. I have created this pretty little design which you could use with any of the colours in your stash, I suppose. All you'd have to do is change out the colour that you're using for the flower and the little patterned strip, and it would be a lot of fun. I have aqua painted this particular flower, but I've got another sample here where we've used a blender pen, and I'll show you the difference. So you can see that. Try and get it to focus a little bit better. There we go. So you can see that up close. This sample has been blender pen. I don't know if you can notice, but the way it's been blended kind of has a little bit of a fabric look to it almost. It's smooth, it's got a little bit of a velvet look. And here is the watercoloured one, so you can see the difference there. The watercolour one has a little bit more texture through it. This one's very smooth, whereas this one's got more of that watercolour look to it. And I think that's really pretty. So that's what I'm going to go with today. Both of them work. Both of them look great, but I do really like this watercolour style. It's not as smooth and it does have that fun element to it, so I'm going to give that a try for you today. So let's give it a go. To start with, I've got just a white standard Whisper White card base, and I've got a piece of retired DSP, but I mentioned these watercolour pencils, there's quite a lot of them. They come in a whole heap of different colours, and you could use any of the patterns from your stash that match in with a paper just to quickly change that up into a different design. I use tape for mine. And just adhere that on there. Open that up and pop it along the edge. There. Next, I've got this little strip. You can see here it's about 3 centimeters wide. It does go the full length of my... Actually, no, it doesn't quite go the full length. I've shorted it about a centimetre. And I'm going to stamp that with this lovely stamp from our Sweet Sentiment stamp set. It says, "Hoping your day is perfect." I mixed it in with a happy birthday, but "Hoping your day is perfect," really, you could just change that up and it could be a wedding card, it could be a Mother's Day card, it could be just about anything. A thank you, a thinking of you. It could be anything. So I'm using just a bit of the Memento. Bear with me 2 seconds. I'm going to grab a sheet to catch any bits that fall off the edge. So I've got a piece of scratch paper there. I'm going to drop that off the side a little bit and create a bit of a typeset pattern all the way down. There we go. Super fast, nice and easy, and then you've got this bold graphic background layer that looks great. All right, again, a little bit of tape to adhere that to the project. I'm going about the same distance here as I've got missing there, so there we go. Next, you need some black cardstock, and I have used my Big Shot and my Stitch Shape framelits. I'm fairly certain that's the largest size circle in the pack, to create that lovely stitched panel. And that can go on with dimensionals. Which is right here. those backings off. And I've got that coming up about a centimetre on that side. The next touch is just a bit of doily. I've torn that one in half, but I might actually bring it in a little bit more. I'm going to use a bit of the tear and tape adhesive for this one. It's just a little panel, but there's not much holding it on, so I'll make sure that that's got something a bit stickier. Pop that there on the angle. I used a couple of sequins. On the design. Now these aren't a stamping up one, they're actually from a company called Pretty Pink Posh. They're just the right pink to really work in this project. I'm going to get my scratch paper back out, and I like to pop a little bit of my glue on there and use my tweezers to pick it up and position it in the right place. Some of my ladies in class like to put the glue directly on the project, but I find this works better for me. Okay. So the last pieces that we need are a sentiment and our flower. Alright. So I've got my flower here. I am stamping that onto a piece of shimmery white cardstock. I don't know if you can see the colours are different. It's like a little bit more vanilla and it's thicker. It's got that shimmer to it. It's really great for colouring. I'm using my Stays On Black. Ink that up really well. Turn that over, position it in place. Give it a really firm press. And we've got a nice, bold, bright flower there. That flower comes from the Birthday Bloom stamp set. Gorgeous set. Really love that flower. And it's perfect for colouring. So I've got some of my pencils here from the watercolour pencil collection that's currently available in Stampin' Up's Occasions catalogue. Very popular. And I'm going to colour. I'm just going to go really deep where there's any shadowing, where you would expect that it would be a bit darker on a petal. I'm going in here. I'm going to continue colouring and put this in fast forward for you so you don't have to watch me go in slow motion or real time. Once you've done and you've applied your pencil, it's time to blend. So as I mentioned before, this one was blender penned and it's a lot smoother. But this one, you've got that fun watercolory look to it. And there's no right or wrong. However you go about it is what works for you. I like to use my aqua painter. So I'm just making sure it's clean, nice and damp, but not too wet. And I'm going to do one colour at a time. So I'm going to do my pinks first. Just lifting that colour and spreading it. Going from where it's deepest and spreading it out to where you would expect it to be lightest. I don't want it to be too neat. So I'll keep moving with this, cleaning my brush as I change colours in between, and then I'll pop it in normal speed again and check back with you. There we go. If you're finding it's a little bit pale and you'd like to deepen some of these colours, that's quite easy to do. Just use your pencil like a palette. Do it over scrap paper as opposed to your project, because you could end up with little flicks. I don't know if I can inadvertently do that to show you. I'm just loading the colour onto my brush directly from the pencil, and I'm going to go back over. Just where I might like it to be darkest. Make sure you've got enough water on there that it's blending well. And that just gives you that little bit of extra dimension and depth. Yeah. And that's our flower. Then it's just a matter of fussy cutting it out and adding it to our card front with some dimensionals. And there we have it, our fussy cut flower. Now, a little word of warning, as I was going around, I thought to myself that maybe it would have been a good idea to have a quick dry off with my heat tool before fussy cutting. I don't know if you noticed there, but some of the areas were still a little damp as I went across. it blended in a little bit of pink in my green. Not that anyone's going to notice, I'm a little bit of a perfectionist like that. And the ladies who know me will watch this video and have a laugh, but that bothers me. But yeah, use your heat tool if your project's still a little bit damp to stop that colour from transferring to your fingers and jumping into a different area on your hard work, on your art. Alright, so that's just going to go on there with some dimensionals. Alright, they're all sticky, the backs are all off. I'm going to pop that up like so on the project. So the last thing, if you want to, you can add a sentiment. You don't need to. I quite enjoy layering the sentiments. I chose to go with the It's Your Birthday from the Confetti Celebration set. But as I said, you could use this really feminine, beautiful card for just about any occasion. All you'd have to do is pull out your teeny tiny sentiments or any other stamp set in your collection that has just a nice skinny stamp like that. So, I've got one I pre-made here. So just stamp that on white, just a piece of the Whisper White cardstock in black Memento ink, and then punch it out using this new punch here. Now, I was asked in class if this is something that I've been using a lot of, and yes, I have used this a heap on projects, but you might not notice because I have a tendency just to cut one or both of the ends off and create just a little rectangle banner like I've done today on this project. It's just really useful to be able to use up papers in your collection and know that when you pop this in you're going to get two very straight lines. It can be hard to do that if you're using your paper trimmer on a smaller offcut or piece of card. So that's just going to go on in there. I've got the flower up a bit higher, so I want to use a half dimensional where this panel is not going to sit on the flower, and a little bit of adhesive, flat adhesive where it is, to stick that in place. And I quite like just slipping it up under there a little bit. Make sure the words are sitting nice and straight. And that's our project for today. I really do hope that you've enjoyed watching that one be put together and that you have a go with some of those techniques at home. Alright, I hope you're feeling inspired. Run along and have some fun playing. Alright, bye.